people out in the streets. And the drug habits, some say they just can't eat. Mothers and robbers, no place seems to be safe.
This is the day that the Lord has made, and I shall rejoice and be glad in it. The Bible admonishes us that everything that has breath to give the Lord praise. I pray that all of you all had a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. I am Bruce Hurst, the senior pastor of the Lee Spring Missionary Baptist Church, and on behalf of the leaders and all the disciples of Lee Spring, we thank you so much for joining in with our live screening. This morning, I want to share a message that was preached back early March of 2020. The message title is Living in the Safety Zone. We know that given the COVID-19 pandemic, that many of us, we are panicking, a lot of anxiety, people are depressed. So we're hoping that this word from the Lord will be a blessing, to you. And again, thank you so very much for being a part of our worship service via live screen.
Oh, you are so worthy, Lord God. Oh, you are so worthy, Lord God. Oh, you are so worthy, Lord God.
Our Father and our God, is another day in the land of the living. The nation is paralyzed about this thing called the coronavirus. But God, we know that you're bigger than that. There ain't nothing that you cannot do. And you told us Christians that you hide us under your wings. You protect us both morning, noon, and night. So thank you for another opportunity to come to the house of worship. Now we pray with the few who are here that you would speak now. Speak through your servant. Use my mouth, my heart, my thoughts, that you might get glory. And Father God, we come against Satan, who has scared some folk away. We're Christians and we're scared. We're praying folk, but yet we are scared. You say that you are our light and our salvation. Whom shall we fear? For you the strength of our life, of whom shall we be afraid? So I pray now for empowerment by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Thank thee. I want to thank our male chorus for leading us this morning.
Amen.
Amen. Thank them. If you would turn to Exodus chapter 9. A word from the Lord this morning. I want to commence with verse 13 and read through verse 16, and then from 22 to 26. Do you have it?
Amen.
The Lord said unto Moses, rise up early in the morning, and stand before Pharaoh, and say unto him, thus said the Lord God of the Hebrews, let my people go that they may serve me. For I will at this time send all my plagues upon thy heart, and upon thy servant, upon thy people, that thou mayest know that there is none like me in all the earth. For now I will stretch out my hand, that I may smite thee and thy people with pestilence, and thou shalt be cut off from the earth. And in very deed, for this cause have I raised thee up, for to show in thee my power, that my name may be declared throughout all the earth.
Amen.
Verse 22, and the Lord said unto Moses, stretch forth thy hand towards heaven, that there may be hail in all the land of Egypt, upon man, upon beast, upon every herb of the field throughout the land of Egypt. And Moses stretched forth his rod toward heaven, and the Lord sent thunder and hail, and the fire ran along upon the ground, and the Lord rained hail upon the land of Egypt. So there was hail and fire mingled with the hail, very grievous, such as there was none like it in all the land of Egypt since it became a nation. And the hail smoke throughout all the land of Egypt, all that was in the field, both man and beast, and the hail smoked every herb of the field and break every tree of the field. Here's the shout. Only in the land of Goshen, where the children of Israel were, was there no hail.
All right. Go ahead. All right.
Only in the land of Goshen, where Lee Springs was there no hail. I want to talk about living in the safety zone. Living in the safety zone. J.C. Dale said, nothing whatsoever, whether great or small, happened to a believer without God's ordering and permission. Mm-hmm. There is no such thing as chance or luck or accident in the Christian journey in this world. God will have his way. No power on earth can stop him when he begins to make a move. When his wheel begins to turn, when his wheel begins to move, nobody can say, God, what are you doing? For God will execute his divine will, his divine plan. He will execute his plan. It was in God's divine will that the children of Israel be free. He told Moses on the backside of Mount Horeb, I have surely seen the affliction of my people, which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters, for I know their sorrow. And I've come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians and bring them up out of the land unto a good land, a land flowing with milk and honey.
All right now, all right.
Now therefore, he repeats it, I've heard the cry of my people, and I have come to deliver them. I've seen their oppression by the evil Pharaoh, but I will certainly bring them out. Moses, on the backside of Horeb, he was concerned about what would he tell Israel. Now, Lord, I will go, but they're going to certainly ask me, what is your name? And what shall I tell them?
Yes.
Just tell them that I am, that I am. That's enough. Just tell them I'm everything that they need. Just tell them I am that I am. Saints of God, Pharaoh refused to let the people go. He had the nerve to raise the interrogative, who is the Lord that I should let his people go? He was hard-hearted, stubborn, obstinate, trusting in his own self rather than putting his trust in God. Sounds just like Donald Trump. God knows how to get Pharaoh's attention. God used devastating plague. The searcher of heart knows a hard heart when he encounters one. But God always amazes me. He always attacks idols. He always attacks images that directly oppose him. God always attacks stuff that we make gods instead of God himself. God sent 10 plagues. Each plague attacks a god of the Egyptian. Each plague attacks an idol. The first plague of bloody waters attacks Osiris, the god of the Nile. The second plague of frogs attacks the frog god Heth. The third plague of life attacks Seb, the earth god. The fourth plague of flies attacked Hathcock, the wife of Osiris. The fifth plague of cattle disease attacks Apis, the sacred bull god. The sixth plague, boils attacked Typhon. The seventh plague, hell and fire attacks Shu, the god of the atmosphere. The eighth plague, locusts attacks Sibrea, the god who protects Egypt against locusts. The ninth plague of darkness attacks Ra, the sun god. And the tenth plague of the death of the firstborn attacks all the gods of Egypt. God forever attacks idols, anything that we use as a substitute for him. I tell you one thing, God has used this coronavirus to attack America's number one idol, the green dollar and greed. God has used this virus to attack America's number one idol, that thing called the dollar. God attacked the stock market this week. The Dow Jones plagued more than 1,080 points. It reached all gains to this point in 2020. Andrew Shays, CEO and founder of Money Crashers, said the global equity market have already lost trillions of dollars. God always attacks idols. Global tourism on track to lose billions of dollars. NCAA men basketball tournament earned $93 million in 2019. Was on track to bring in $1.1 million, but now all of that is gone. God always attacks idols. The NBA Basketball League is on track to lose billions of dollars. If the NBA canceled the rest of the season, LeBron James will lose $200,000 a game, $9 million for the rest of the year. God attacks idols then, God attacks idols now, and God will attack idols forever. Anything that does not exalt the name of the Lord, he will attack. The Lord will attack.
Yes, he will.
The Lord uses the plagues as an attempt to reach the heart of the infidel,
yes,
the unbeliever.
Yes.
It's right here in the 14th and 15th verse. For I will this time send all my plagues upon thy heart, upon thy servants, that thou may know there's none like me.
Yes.
In verse 16, in very deed for this cause,
yes,
have I raised thee up for my power, and that my name may be declared throughout all the earth. The Lord is trying to reach the heart of those who do not know him. The heart of the unbeliever. Charles Swindell, a great biblical expositor, tells of how he met a physician for dinner. They met by appointment. He was one of the finest orthopedic surgeons in Southern California. For the better part of his practice, he confided he had given himself without reservation to making money. He made it by the hundreds of thousands of dollars. By the time he was in his late 40s, he was extremely wealthy. But he was a man who had no time or thought for God. Work consumed him. Some days he worked 18 to 20 hours a day. He began to rely on narcotics that he administered to his patients for pain.
All right, now.
Over time, the brilliant surgeon became addicted to heroin and other drugs.
Right.
He lost his credentials. Following that, in short order, he lost his reputation.
Right.
His home, his wife, and his children. He lost everything. It was as if one plague after another plague beat upon him until he was finally crushed beneath the hands of a living God.
Right.
This broken Jewish physician discovered the answer to his crushing problem. He swallowed his pride,
yes,
and admitted his spiritual emptiness, yes, and gave his heart to Christ.
All right,
after dinner, he told Pastor Swindell, "For the first time in my life, I can really say I have peace. I've come from judgment,
yes,
to a whole new life in grace."
Yes.
And he said, "I have to tell you, the most important thing to me is not my practice, not my money, not my family, but my relationship to God." This infidel gave his heart to God and said, "There's none like him, and his name is worthy to be praised." Of course, you are not an infidel. You're not an unbelievable. But why can't you say that there's none like him? Why come you can't declare his name? Is it your feelings? Is it your fears? Is it your failures? Your doubts? Some of you come Sunday by Sunday. You're not moved by anything. Singing don't move you. Praying don't move you. The word don't move you.
something wrong with you. If the Lord of the Lord can't never stir you up sometime, I wouldn't have a God that I couldn't feel sometime. I will declare his name. You don't have to declare his name. I'll declare his name. He saved my soul. I'll declare his name. Brought me from a mighty long way. I will declare his name. Brought me through college. Healed me when I was sick. Made a way out of no way. Kept me when mama was dead. I will declare his name in all the earth. Put a fence around me in the midst of hurricane winds. He's been too good to me not to declare his name. The Lord has been too good to me not to praise his name. And saints of God, you got to get to the part. You got to say, I don't care what no Negroes say, what no Negroes do. When they come, when I think of the goodness of the Lord and all he done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah! Thank God for saving me. I'm through. The Lord attacked idols. The Lord tried to influence the heart of the infidel. But then the Lord imposes his authority. The text says that it hailed and thunder and fire ran along the ground. Never saw that before. God got fire running across the land. The hail was mingled with the fire. And the Bible makes it clear that it hailed all over the land of Egypt. It destroyed the beasts. It destroyed men. It destroyed the trees. It destroyed vegetations in all of Egypt. But in verse 26, it said, but those in Goshen, where the children of Israel live, there was no hail. They were living in the safety zone. Now remember that Goshen is just a few miles down the road from Egypt. But there was no hail, no fire, no thunder. No fire running on the ground because they were living in the safety zone. Do you remember when I said earlier that the Lord said, these are my people. I've heard their cry. I've seen their affliction. You missed it. He said, they are my people. And because they are my people, they're living in the safety zone. Now, don't that amazes me? Hail everywhere. Hail all over the land of Egypt. But in Goshen, there was no hail. I'm glad this morning that he calls me by his name. He calls you by his name. He calls us sons and daughters of God. He calls us a peculiar generation. He calls us his saints. Calls us his friends. Called us the called out one. He calls us the marvelous one. And because we're his children, we're living in the safety zone. I'm glad about it. I'm not worried about the coronavirus. God's on my side. If the Lord's on my side, the Lord will protect us. The Lord will cover us. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. He'll look after his children. He will look after his children. Yes, he will. That's why when I go home after second service, I go home, say my prayer, lay down, and go to sleep. And then he wakes me up in the morning, get back on my knees, thank you for a brand new day, and going about my business. Next night I come home, take off my clothes, take a bath, say my prayer, go to bed. He wakes me up, Lord, thank you for another day. That's what I'll do. Amen. Because I'm living in a safety zone. In a safety zone. Some of you are saying, but Pastor, that wasn't, I didn't really get it because I've seen it raining Main Street, but down the road it won't raining. Yeah, but it won't rain in fire.
Go ahead.
And it won't rain in hell. And the hell wasn't killing people. This hell was killing man, beasts, and everything. Can't you see the people in Goshen going about their daily activity? Life was normal for them because no hell was in Goshen because of where the people of God. I'm not saying that no Christian would not be contracted with the coronavirus. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying if we do, I know he's a healer.
Amen.
I do know that. He's a wonderful healer. He's Jehovah Rapha. But do know because you're a Christian, you in the safety zone. Now if you're here this morning and you're not a Christian, you in a bad zone. And you're not safe. Because if he came for you now, if you don't know where you will spend eternity, you're in a bad zone. May we all stand. If you're here this morning, you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord of your life, would you please come and give your life to Christ with everyone who will come? With everyone who will come this morning. The Bible says, if you confess the Lord Jesus Christ with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. With the heart, man, believe on the righteous, with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. With everyone who will come. With everyone who will come. With everyone who will come. Would you come for prayer this morning that the Lord will cover you from all manner of illness, from all manner of disease, from all manner of viruses.
Jesus. Right now, acknowledging you just for who you are.
Yes.
God, we know you to be everything that we need to be.
Yes, Lord.
And God, for that we say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
God, we can't thank you enough for the many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. God, dangers seen and unseen that you kept us from. Lord, you are truly a keeper. God, we thank you right now for all the ways that you have made for us. When we feel like we didn't deserve it, you still made a way.
Yes, Lord.
God, we thank you for your grace, and we thank you for your mercy.
Yes, Lord.
God, right now, in the name of Jesus, whatever the issue is right now at the altar, you said, cast it at my feet, for I care for you.
Yes,
and right now, we're casting all at your feet, Jesus.
Yes,
for I know if you can take care of the little bird,
yes,
oh, I know you can take care of me.
Yes.
And God, we say thank you right
thank
now
you,
for whatever the issue is, whether it's health related,
yes,
medical condition, financially, emotional crisis,
right,
a spiritual problem. God, we know you got the answer and that you sure enough can fix it. God, I thank you right now for this church.
Yes, Lord.
How you have kept us all through the years.
Yeah.
I thank you right now for the under shepherd. That you have sent to be ahead of us. God, one that truly cares for people. God, I thank you for the relationship of pastor and people. God, I thank you right now for those that are not here. For you have not given us the spirit of fear. But I'm so glad we can walk with a sound mind. To know that we are covered under you. In the name of Jesus. I don't care what may be on the outside, God. Because we know that we're living in the safety zone.
Yes.
God, we ask you right now that you bless us,
yes,
continue to protect us, and continue to cover us.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus,
yes,
we declare and decree that it is so.
Yes.
And the redeemer of the Lord said amen.
Amen.
And they said amen again.
Amen.
And they said amen one more time.
Amen.